Hugestin, I'm a friend. Medea, I bid you take your angry looks, the resentment for your husband and both your children, and leave this land in exile immediately.
I am the victim. Creon, why are you chasing me away?
I fear you. I fear you might irreparably hurt my child. It's better for me to incur your hatred now, lady, than to bitterly cry afterward because of my weakness.
You fear me? Why? What harm have you done to me? You gave your daughter in marriage to whomever you thought right. It's my husband, I think. I wish you all the happiness you deserve, but let us stay in this life.
Your words sound strangely soft. Meekness is more dangerous than guile. I'm afraid you might be plotting some mischief in your heart.
So you will banish me and have no pity for my prayers.
I don't love you more than I love my family. It's my daughter I care for.
Ah! What a horrible disgrace for mankind. Love.
That really depends on the turn our fortunes take.
We will leave, I swear we will.
Why then are you defying my decree? Why don't you just leave?
Just give me one day. One more day, Creon. So that I can come up with a plan for the exile and the means of sustenance for the children. Their father is not thinking about them. Creon, you are a father too! Have pity on them! This is not about me. Exile is not new to me, Creon.
My nature is not that harsh. You'll get what you're asking for. I warn you, though. One day only. Or you die.
Thank you.
the pain and humiliation they are inflicting on me. And besides, we are just women. Not very good at anything, really. Except one thing.
Come to an agreement with the sovereign of the city. But there was nothing I could do to keep you here. But I heard that you've been granted one more day.
This is the great news. It will give you the time to arrange for a better match.
Oh, Jason. What a wonderful surprise.
You women have this strange idea. You think all is well
as long as your married life runs smooth.
But if some issue raises in your bed, all that was good and lovely turns
into the worst possible
evil.
Only day every day.
Have you actually listened to the will of your superiors? You could just stay here,
in peace. But now, don't you be banished for your hateful word,
banished.
Yet even after this, I'm not the kind of person who forgets about their loved ones.
And this is the reason I'm here.
I don't want that you and our children won't be destitute or lacking hanging while away. Exile is a hard thing to face. I know. And even though you hate me, I could never think badly of you. Yeah.
Thank you. enter there and enter out, we be for that.
Thank you.
over spread over the palace. One kiss the children's heads. Another one wrap them in their arms. As for myself, I follow the children into the women's corner.
Punished!
punished by those you ruined.
Children!
Thank you.
Children, you're going to a new place. And I cannot come. I will be there. I will be there when you grow up. I will be there to let you go.
Yeah.
Ladies, come to me! David! Children!
This will torture you!
myself.
You sickening murderers. You...
Go home.
Thank you, Alessandro. I want to say thank you. Everyone invite you. If you come along, just visit Teatro Patologico. It's a magic place. We have a beautiful theater. You can sleep with us. I am not here. I'm sick. You can sleep with us, not in my home. Because I didn't but you can eat. But especially if you can see the work we're doing, theater therapy will be amazing and incredible healthy. So now, Fabio, this is Pathological, is most strong for atomic bomb. Perché Teatro Patologico don't kill people, ma Teatro Patologico make change the idea of the people. Perfetto. Lui sa tutto della bomba atomica. Come fa la bomba atomica? Ok, metti la bomba.
Punto.